Meditation is to not be lost in the mind, but to see the mind. And this can liberate us from so much unnecessary suffering in life. It liberates us from illusions. What are the illusions? Misidentification with what we are not. Identification with a character that we play, a character in a dream, in the simulation which the mind creates. And to see this simulation, to have no illusions about it, means that we live in a different reality. It doesn't mean that what we generally call reality is going to change, but we experience it differently because our relationship with the reality has changed. Before, we were in this simulation, it is often called also in spirituality, in this dream, and we took this dream to be our lives. Now we see the dream. And just like a dream that you can have in a night or in an afternoon, in a reverie, or when you wake up and you are suddenly relieved from what was going on in that dream, that clarity. So this meditation, the short meditation, is a way to look at the mind and not be lost in it. And I find that this can help sometimes, because normally when we start to look at our minds, we are so identified with every thought that arises that for some people it's very difficult to actually get distance and not engage with everything. So let's try something playful. Let's imagine that there is this new technology now that we can look and experience others' body-mind. For example, you can experience my body-mind and take a look what is going on. And the way we do it, the switch, is by closing our eyes. So what we are going to do is I'm going to refer to myself and to you as this person. And we are just observers. Maybe we are not even humans. Maybe we are an artificial intelligence that wants to know about humans. And it has consciousness now. And it is coming as a visitor in this human body mind, taking a look. So none of the things that you will see are yours, obviously. You are just looking into this person's dream, ball of experience, or reality. You want to try that with me? I hope so. So, before closing our eyes, let's just see and look at this body, look at this person's body, and see it from this place of curiosity. Okay, what is going on in here? Can we see it? Let's just start taking a couple of breaths through our nose and a very slow exhale and pay attention to the body. Now bring up all your curiosity, because we are going to visit this body-mind. And when we close our eyes, we can see what is going on inside this person. So when you are ready for this experience, close your eyes. And first take a look at what is going, what are sensations How does a human body feel? How does the inside of this body feel? Maybe the movements of air, tinglings. Maybe a heartbeat. If you really bring our curiosity and attention, it's a strange world we are looking and sensing into. There are sounds. So now we are getting a sense of this human body, the different senses, let's scan those. You're just curious to see how does the fingertips feel. How does air feel and a smell? How is hearing? What is hearing? Now let's see what's more in this body, mind, in this person. You might already have noticed that there's a mind, there's thoughts, stream of them. Let's take a look. Remember, none of these are yours. You're just a visitor in here. You're just curious. There seems to be a voice in this person's head. Can you sometimes hear it? It's self-referential most of the time. Maybe this person at this moment that you are observing has many ideas about what he's going to do in 10 minutes or next day, or worrying about something. What is in their dream now? What is in this simulation of their mind right now as you're observing? Is this a happy dream you're observing, or you rather want to get out? Just observe. And if you find that you lost your observation and gone away in a thought, remember that you're observing. Come back. just see this miracle of this simulation, this totality of thoughts and sense and emotions and sounds and take one good last look around, because we are ready to say goodbye. Just with curiosity, how inside of this person was. And when you are ready, open your eyes. It can be a curious experience, isn't it? To experience what is going on, what we normally take to be our life and our reality, in this way, from this distance, can be liberating. It is identification with what you saw going on, identification with that voice in the mind, identification with the next thought that arises in that mind, that has the character of being in a dream, being in that simulation, being lost in that simulation. When we look at it this way, it gives us the disassociation with that voice that we took to be ourselves. We see how our mind is creating a reality. And if our reality is not a very joyful one, especially, is not the then it is a really a nightmare that we are living. And this is the way to be free from it. And now, the mind, once it is liberated from this small self, this all these small ideas about me, and all the worries and all this, when these fall away, the mind is the most beautiful tool in the universe. We are not used now by our minds, but we can use our minds. So it is, the mind is no more the source of suffering and imaginary suffering, but it becomes what it can be, which is the source of creativity and imagination. I believe that's why we are here, not to suffer, but to be a joyful vessel of creation. I hope you enjoyed this one.